Because of our unique location directly across the street from the ocean, Florida Oceanographic Society is able to create an ecosystem that resembles the Indian River Lagoon.
This exhibit is specific to kind of showcase game fish species. So it's 750,000 gallons and it's fed with raw ocean water. We pump about 500 gallons a minute and a majority of that goes to this exhibit.
This part of Florida is a water-driven world. People live here and people visit here because they love the water. Our economy is built around tourism and a big part of that is fishing tourism.
The animals that live inside of it, all the game fish species, could be impacted negatively if the ocean water was to become toxic in some way.
Here in Stuart, we're mostly concerned with what's coming out of Lake Okeechobee in the St. Lucie estuary. Pulses of up to 1 billion gallons a day of water for nearly the entire year last year have resulted in unnatural salinity patterns. Even if that fresh water coming out of Lake Okeechobee was clean enough to drink, it's still a pollutant. When you dump 1 billion gallons a day of fresh water into a marine system, plants and animals start to suffer. Our seagrasses die, our oysters die, our fish start to die. That water, even if it's clean as can be, is still a harmful pollutant. But it's not clean. The water coming out of Lake Okeechobee carried with it a massive bloom of cyanobacteria. That cyanobacterial bloom, those blue-green algal organisms, produce toxins. Toxins that are harmful to us, toxins that are harmful to the entire ecosystem.
The algae, well, it's actually a bacteria, just behaves like an algae. When it gets stressed, and since it's a freshwater animal, it releases its toxins in stressed situations. And when it hits that full strength ocean water, that's a highly stressful situation. So we were afraid that toxic load was gonna be really high right at that inlet. And then if we got a northern kind of current, we would pull it in. It can accumulate in fish in their livers, and it might not kill the fish, but then if birds and dolphins or other animals eat enough of those fish, it could become toxic to those animals.
The Indian River Lagoon is a phenomenal system. It was considered one of the most biodiverse ecosystems in all of North America historically. I'd argue that that's probably not the case today. The entire system is like one critically ill patient dealing with multiple system failures. The northern Indian River Lagoon is dealing with its own algae blooms. Those blooms of brown and green algae are having equally devastating effects. The green and brown algae blooms in the northern Indian River Lagoon are responsible for the death of more than 47,000 acres of seagrass. Those issues combine to create a potential devastating scenario for the entire Indian River Lagoon. If we don't act now to fix the problems that are destroying these ecosystems, they won't be left for future generations to enjoy like I have.